So I just put the resin, is it same as flux or?
It's, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Okay.
Yeah. So you can apply liquid flux beforehand.
Yeah.
Or a resin, there's also resin in here, and usually that's enough.
Yep.
But for smaller pitched objects, it can be handy to use a flux. We don't have a flux here, but you can get for it, you can buy a flux pen to apply it. So now I put one side, the other side I leave dry. Because I want my component to lay perfectly flat. And with the solder iron, I can't heat both places at the same time. So take the component, have my nice warm, my puddle of solder here, and I heat that up again. So I bring the solder iron in. And I put the component into the hot one nice warm puddle. And let take the solder iron out, still holding the component. And I can let the component go. Then what I do, I revisit it, I put my
the
suppliers,
yep.
On top. Push a little bit on it, not like pushing down on it, but just leaning on it a little bit. And I reheat the solder. That way I make sure that that it's perfectly flat. Mm-hmm. Because solder is not a conductor. It's a bit of glue, but it's not meant to conduct electricity. It does conduct electricity, the tin, but it's better if you have the component actually sitting on the copper. But the bulk of the electronics, the electrons, are going through that connection. This is just to fill the gap. It's not, if it's high up, it's not supposed to bridge things. You can use it that way, but it's not supposed to. It's better to have a flat on the surface. Especially when you get around your crystal, it's important to get everything nice and flat. Okay. Then we can go around to the other side. And what we do is, because remember we can't put some solder on here and then glue it on, you also can't paint with solder. So if you cut it on one side, you can't drag it over to the other side. That doesn't work. So we do is put the solder iron in the corner between the pan and the component. And then I add solder right into that corner there. A little bit enthusiastic.
Ooh, good.
So what we have now is on the board here, we've got solder on one side, got solder on the other side. Now sometimes, if you've got a bigger component, sometimes it's good to revisit your old solder joint, if it's not nice and shiny. See this solder joint? Both of them are nice and shiny. If they're not nice and shiny, you need to revisit them, heat them up again, and add a little bit more solder. That will make it shiny. If you've got too much solder, you need to use a solder blade to take the solder away again. And if it's got fresh solder,
the advantage of using flux paste.
Okay, flux paste will help the flux paste will help to flow.